Good morning, coffee drinkers. Few really important things before we get to today's kick-ass. I gotta say it's kick-ass. I don't normally say, okay, what I do is great, but I'm still, I just feel like I'm hitting my stride, like so almost a decade into the process of having Janek Space Studio, of making content, of filming videos, and like getting inside my technique. I think with this new technique course that we just launched at the Base Studio, I think I really hit the stride and found just so many great fundamentals to share with you guys. That lesson is coming up in just a second. If you want to check out the whole course, it is linked below. Another very important thing is that the podcast is back, the Janek Gwizdala podcast. It is the Hello Coffee Drinkers podcast from here on out. Three or four new episodes this week already. Go check it out. There are going to be guests. There's going to be me ranting solo. There are going to be guests. There are going to be all kinds of things, playing, bootlegs, analyzing music, transcriptions, you name it. That is also linked below. You can listen on iTunes, Stitcher, directly at the website or wherever you listen to podcasts. If you want to get a discount on chordal harmony, you can do that. It's linked below. Use the code BASECHORDS at checkout, and you can get a 15% discount on chordal harmony right now. That's all linked below. But let's get into the lesson. Right-hand technique. The course that is up on the Base Studio is left-hand technique, right-hand technique, all the things in between, chords, palm muting, false harmonics, all aspects of bass technique and how I approach them. And of course, you guys ask so many questions about action and about technique and strap height and left knee, right knee, standing, sitting, pick, thumb, fingers, all those things. I put it all in a course. It's several hours long. We just launched the first part of it, which is all about the right hand technique. That is what I'm going to give to you guys right now, a little sneak preview. One of the lessons, I think this is lesson 5 of 7 in the first chapter. So this is all about palm muting, one of my favorite techniques, something I use ever such a lot, and something if you've ever heard me play music, you've definitely heard me do it. So let's get to it. Right hand, palm muting, the ultimate technique course for bass guitar. Let's take a look at a favorite technique of mine, something I employ all the time when I'm playing live, playing solo, playing with a band, changing the dynamic of a groove. It's the kind of the crab claw thing. It's the palm muting technique with your picking hand. For me, I'm right-handed, it's my right hand. And whereas I was talking before about how much meat you have on the side of your thumb, how possible it is to mute all these strings as you play rest stroke, it's something, if you've heard me play, you've definitely heard me do it. And it's something that is quite distinctive in sound. It gives it a little more punch. And there's a lot of range in it as well, because I don't exclusively mute all the strings all the time. I try and use it as dynamically as possible. That is what I want to talk to you about right now. Palm muting is very simple in concept. Instead of the thumb doing the muting, it's the back of the palm right here. Really easy way to get the right position is to just, like you were gonna chop the end off your bass, put that right in front of the bridge and just roll it forward slightly. That's the basic position. Now, in terms of the crab claw, in terms of the technique that I use, I push down with the thumb and I pull up with the fingers. So instead of the hand being straight, being at right angles to the strings, it's definitely at an angle. Sometimes it's almost parallel to the strings when I'm doing it. But you have to find what's comfortable for you. Obviously, not everyone's positioning is going to be the same. You may be standing, sitting, left knee. It works on the right knee as well. A little more uncomfortable for me, I got to say. I have a little more range. It feels like I have more range when the bass is on the left knee for me. But you'll find what's comfortable for you and adapt accordingly. I can't give you one angle of the right hand that's gonna work no matter what, but I can give you the ballpark and let you make the adjustments to what suits you and to what's comfortable. So again, like you're gonna chop the bridge off your bass, that's this side, the back of the hand right here, and then you roll it in slightly to where you can make contact with the thumb. Now you might wanna think about the thumb as a pick. If you had a pick and you were just making all downstrokes, so the thumb
is kind of basically a downstroke pick. We'll get to double thumbing later. That's down, down, up. But for now, let's just go with the down. Your up, for me at least, is the middle finger. That's my main one. And the first finger. It's not necessarily alternating. I don't play too many. I don't play too many linear ideas like this. This is a lot. I use this a lot in terms of groove playing, and it tends to be the middle finger that's the more dominant upstroke. So in this little groove, all I'm using is my thumb and my middle finger. Now I am making a little percussive kind of clap sound, like a snare drum on 2 and 4. That's out of habit. It's not a particularly good technique. It works well if I'm playing on my own, if I'm setting up a groove in the looper, or if it's like a breakdown section. It doesn't work so well if you're recording and you get this kind of sound coming in on the recording. Engineers, producers don't particularly enjoy that one very much. So basically what I'm doing here is we're in E, and I'm plucking down with the thumb, and it's muted, it's not ringing open. If I play this whole idea open, it would sound a very different dynamic. So the palm is definitely muting everything, and it's giving it a little more punch, a little less tail on the shape of the note, a little less sustain. And it, to me, it feels like I can be a little more percussive, kind of find a few more nuances in the middle of the groove, but kind of feeling and thinking and playing a little bit more like a drummer. It's really the rhythmic element of the right hand to me, aside from the actual muting itself, is the thing that really is the crux of this style of playing. And the line is very simple. I can explain that to you very quickly. It's just E and then D, E. And the second time I'm coming from D to C sharp. And actually that percussive thing I'm getting is my second, it's my middle finger. Literally just clicking the G string right there. And depending on how hard I do it, it might make contact with the pickup. That gives a little more pronounced 2 and 4 kind of backbeat. But it's subtle. It can get way more pronounced. You see, I'm pulling my whole hand off the bass there. But really, whenever I'm doing this, especially when I'm explaining it like this, I'm trying to be repetitive. So I'm sticking with the same idea. Some little kind of funk idea in E. But you also heard me play a couple of fills here and there, employing the same technique. It's still muted. But it's, to me, the nuance and the kind of the details about where I lift the hand off so certain elements aren't muted, and then get back to the hand being on to where they are. So if I'm playing quite a tight groove, just the basic groove, everything is muted. And then I just lift it off. You saw my right hand come off as I hit that G and really let it ring out, just to give that variation. It gave that kind of lift in the groove, and then back to the muted thing. Little subtleties like that, things we're all capable of playing that note. I'm highly confident that everyone watching this video is capable of playing that note right there. And I'm also pretty sure everyone can play a simple muted E string. So if you were having any doubts or apprehensions about the palm muting technique, I think you are way closer to having that variation between open strings and palm muted strings than you think. Mm-hmm.